From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Maine's top election official says nothing he has seen on Election Day has prompted him to change his projection for a relatively low voter turnout. Secretary of State Matthew Dunlap says turnout has been stronger than expected in some places, including Harpswell and Waldoboro, where extra ballots were requested. But he says that overall turnout will be around 20%, just as projected last week. That's on the high side for an off-year election, but far below 70% in a typical presidential election. On the ballot are 11 Republicans and Democratic gubernatorial hopefuls, as well as a tax overhaul law and four bond packages totaling $108 million. The League of Young Voters is using this primary election day to get out their message and drum up support for a controversial issue of allowing non-U.S. citizens the right to vote in Portland city elections. The group out the polls all day today collecting signatures for their petition. And they were trying to put a referendum on this November's ballot, which would allow legal immigrants in Portland a chance to vote in city elections. In order to get the issue on the ballot, the group needs signatures from 5,000 registered voters in Portland. League members were at each polling place today to get those signatures.
It's kind of difficult in that the people that you're working to help and provide a voice to aren't allowed to collect signatures and aren't allowed to sign. So it really is finding the people that really truly believe that democracy and diversity are important in Portland and think this is worthy to be voted on.
The League of Young Voters has to turn in signatures by July 14th in order to be counted for the November election. Four teenagers are in custody tonight after South Portland police say they robbed a man staying at the Econo Lodge on John Roberts Road last night. Investigators say the guests knew one of the suspects and actually invited the group into his room. And that is when they say the teens choked the victim and then threatened him with a knife. An officer with a canine unit later tracked down the three 19-year-old suspects in the parking lot of Marshall's. Police also arrested a 17-year-old. The alleged victim suffered minor injuries and officers recovered a stolen laptop and other items. Police in Biddeford are looking for the robber who pulled out a weapon at the Rite Aid Pharmacy on Alfred Street shortly before noon today. Police say the man got away with some drugs and so far no arrests have been made. An Ohio hiker who spent 3 days lost near Maine's highest peak after leaving a hiking trail will not have to pay for his rescue. Baxter State Park officials say the rules would allow them to charge 41-year-old Michael Hayes of Stowe, Ohio, with the cost of the search. They found him May 31st after he had been injured his knee and couldn't walk out on his own. More than a quarter of a century later, and the Maine law enforcement torch run is still going strong, helping raise funds and awareness for Special Olympics Maine. More than 600 members of Maine law enforcement started the trek across the state today, and the law enforcement torch run is one of Maine's largest fundraising events for Special Olympics. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We'll be right back.